Good afternoon and welcome to the first exhibition in Italy of the two Canadian artists, Nathalie Frenière and Lise Biel-Boulet. They are friends and they love to exhibit together because they have the same sensibility, the same world towards nature. That it's a remind, a feeling, romanticism that seems to be forgotten in contemporary times because people think that it's a signal of frailty, of weakness, even if romanticism was protagonist in the painting of some years ago, not so much. But quietly distant from now. Until the 19th century, painters didn't underline the contact between interiority and nature because the major commitments were the church, who wanted religious subjects, and the noblest, the rich people who wanted to have portraits where they can recognize them, where they can have a remembering of themselves and of their families. But at the beginning of the 19th century, there was a movement, Romanticism, who had in English exponents a particular attention to nature, especially William Turner, who expresses all this feeling of strength of nature that is called the sublime, no? The contract position between the strength of nature, the power of nature, and the frailty of human being. Or, for example, John Constable, who talked about nature in a nostalgic way because he painted scenes and places of his childness, so he remembered about this in a tender way, and this kind of interpretative approach to nature was then taken as inspiration also from the Impressionists, even if they considered nature in a more objective way, that was the contact with beauty, with the beauty of the I was falling down of the beauty of the landscapes they wanted to paint, but even if they wanted to have a more they were concentrated on beauty, it's impossible not to feel feelings and sensation and emotions facing Claude Monet's landscape, no? They were full of poetry. And after this, Art Nouveau wanted to maintain this, to keep this contact with nature in a different way. Art Nouveau, it was called Liberty Style, Modernism, and depending on the nations from where the painters or the artists belonged, and what was the innovation? They wanted to have nature, no, as decorations of on everything. skills become part of art. So jewelry, wood, working on wood, ceramics and glasses, decoration of glasses, lose their only useful role, and they became important as art was. And so in particular ceramics had a great importance in this artistic period, because it wasn't only part of objects useful, it became wonderful and full of poetry as art. And it is in this context that we find the partnership of Lise Dialoulet and Nathalie Frenière, because they are great interpreters of romanticism, if we want to call it, because in some way they put, even they are different, they put their articles in deep contact because of the energy, of the tenderness, of the how can you say, of the empathy they show with their feelings, you know. And the actors put it in contact each other, and they have an important important path into art in Ontario and in Montreal, where they had important roots also in institutions, and they love to exhibit together, because from one side they want to reveal the happiness and the you feel when you look at nature, and on the other side they became aware of their feelings and of their approach to nature, that is the only way to live with nature, even if contemporary men often forgets this contact. So Nathalie Frenière talks about has suggestions of seas, of skies, and so you feel conquered by her tenderness, of her will to look up and let you be emotioned by what she's talking about. And on the other side, Lise Dialoulet chooses ceramics, but also abstract expressionism, because she wants to underline the need to detach from everything that the eyes knows, to let yourself go to emotions. And this is their common point. They both leave the rationality and the realistic approach, because if you are too realist, you cannot let yourself go to the emotion. You cannot think about your feelings. And so, abstract expressionism in Lise Dialoulet with tender colors. So it's not strong in her abstract expressionism, but she uses yellows and greens and violet, all colors that can put in contact with the soul. And while Nathalie Frenier too talks about landscapes that could be here or in every other place in the world. You only can imagine, you could be the protagonist of the imagination of the to put this landscapes she talks about wherever you want. From both of them, there is no possibility to live a life without the contact of nature, to listen to the emotion, to put your head up and look at what is over your head, or what is in the waters, no? As for example, the ceramics of Louise Bielgolet, because she always leaves an openness, no? They seem to be broken, as it happens really during the transportation. In fact, downstairs there is an installation of the broken pieces of what, as a memory of what happened during this travel to Italy. And they are always open, as if there was no possibility to keep the emotions inside. And so the strength of emotion, of sensation, should go out to put in contact with all the outside energies. And this is the strength of the of these Bielgolet ceramics, while they dialogue with through colors and also through emotions, vibration, emotionally vibration with the landscapes, with the paintings, tender, soft landscapes of Nathalie Frenier. So this is what makes Armand Xomo Gallery Florence so magic, no? There is a magic atmosphere inside this gallery, because we breathe emotions, we breathe romanticism, we breathe contact with our inner feelings, and the observer seems to be taken by hand from the artist, and to leave himself going to contact with these vibrations, with these suggestions that they evoke thanks to their beautiful art. And inside this environment, inside this this atmosphere, you can feel the movement of the clouds, the movement, the flowing of the waters coming down from these ceramics. You can feel the smell of flowers, and you can come back in touch with your feelings, all the visitors, and also every people who wants to remember, not to forget, the romantic part of themselves. So I invite you in visiting this wonderful exhibition that will be in Florence from the 5th today of August until the 20th of August, and it's a wonderful occasion to buy an artwork of these two important Canadian artists who have made exhibitions all over the world with great success because the cause of this success you can feel coming here in the gallery and looking at this wonderful artworks. But come until the 20th of August in Armando Somo Gallery, Florence, Via di Bellina, 150, 107, 111. We wait for you.